This week's drill is brought to you by Swim for Japan. Pick up a cap and help tsunami victims. Go to swimforjapan.org and order yours. There's more than one way to use your favorite piece of equipment. Flutter Kick with a Pull-Buoy will help you develop a smoother, faster backstroke and freestyle. Why do it? If you have some flaws in your kick, the Pull-Buoy will point them out right away. Doing Flutter Kick with a Pull-Buoy can help you develop lots of good habits with your kick. In order to move down the pool at all, you have to point your toes and keep the kick quick, compact, and steady. How to do it? Hold your Pull-Buoy between your thighs just as you would for a pull set. You'll find that for kicking, a one-piece Pull-Buoy is a little easier to hold in place than a two-piece Pull-Buoy. Push off on your back with your arms at your sides and start flutter kicking. Rotate. Take 6 to 9 kicks on one side, then rotate your entire body, except your head, to the other side. Take 6 to 9 kicks to that side, then rotate again. Keep your head steady, looking straight at the ceiling, even as you rotate your body from one side to the other. Keep your toes pointed straight. Keep the kick narrow and fast. Kick from the thighs and not from the knees. Your feet and toes should be right at the surface. After 1 or 2 lengths, remove the Pull-Buoy and swim a few lengths of backstroke, focusing on pointed toes and narrow kick. Then repeat the cycle, a few lengths with the Pull-Buoy, and then a few lengths of backstroke. How to do it really well, the fine points. Maintain a quick, steady rhythm with your feet. Maintain a steady rhythm with your side-to-side rotation. Try not to use your hands too much. Try alternating a few lengths of Pull-Buoy flutter with a few lengths of backstroke. Another benefit of this is that you'll really feel it in the inside of your legs. Holding the Pull-Buoy while trying to kick requires you squeezing the Pull-Buoy. You'll feel it after a few lengths.